Football League is on the air. The atmosphere here, electric. No matter the venue, the home folks love their silver and black. They are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with the Detroit Lions. And we are underway at Allegiant Stadium. Pulls it in at the 13. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. And right away they're going to stack him up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. They'll fake the handoff. Now Goff. That's caught by the big tight end, T.J. Hockenson. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. On first and 10, it's Swift. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Divine Diablo. And the Raiders are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
Well, normally you see three tight ends in a formation. You have to think to yourself, this has got to be a run. And I know as a safety, when I saw that, I took an extra step or two towards the line of scrimmage. Instead, they threw the ball, and he found one of those tight ends for a very nice pickup.
And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. On first down, Carr dancing to his left. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Jacobs. That catch good for only a couple. Got it here at the 29 on second and 8. Carr gonna throw. Flush to his right. And Carr gives himself up, but not before he picks up a first down. Carr going to try and throw on third down. Buying time to his left. And he wisely will throw that one away.
You absolutely have to have this early on, right? Third and short, they elect to throw for it. And that's normal NFL football. They're going to throw on third and short, but you've got to hit it, don't you?
Yeah, in the first quarter, like you said, to set the tone, can't connect there. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. In lieu of the sneak on fourth and inches, they just say, give it to the big man in the backfield.
Yeah, fullback no less. Not many of those left in the NFL, but for those that have one, perfect time to use them. Perfect time.
And he finds Waller in the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Darren Waller there to make the grab. And the Raiders have taken the early lead. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. Pulls it in at the 13. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going.
finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
And now a hook up downfield on second down. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. A big connection on that one. 31 yards. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
On first down, Goff. And that's going to be knocked away and incomplete. And when the time has expired on the first quarter. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second and 10, Goff again. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Nate Hobbs. And the Raiders are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. Escaping the pressure right. Got a man. It's Darren Waller. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big play there for the Raiders. Being chased out left. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. To throw, it's Carr. You saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Picked off at the 18. A throw he probably shouldn't have made. Rolling left and then throwing back across the field.
And when you do that and you're rolling towards the sideline, you cut down your field in a big way, significantly. And the guys who play in the second and the third level, those linebackers and DBs, they know that. And they know they don't have nearly as much space to cover. And they're hoping you try and throw it back towards the middle.
On second and 11 now, Goff. He finds his man complete. It's Kennedy. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
And that is incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Out of the gun, Goff. Over the middle, and there's a diving catch.
And not all spectacular catches are the result of a pass that maybe was not thrown quite right. Sometimes it's thrown in the perfect spot, and you have to just go get it. He did that right there.
No fear there in the middle of the field. Goff throwing again. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Love the idea, love the concept, but you got to leave a little room on the sideline so he can fade into it when he makes the catch. That was thrown too close to it for the receiver to make a play.
And this shot downfield on second down is brought in. And in for the Lions touchdown. Khalif Raymond, 53 yards. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Extra point by Seibert, up and good, and we are tied here in the second quarter. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Out of the end zone comes Johnson. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
On first down, they go with Jacobs again. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4. Carr going to give it to Jacobs. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. They got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a third and two more. Here's Carr to throw. He's got a man, it's his fullback. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Throwing now is Carr. He'll get this one complete to Zay Jones. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Carr now to throw. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Throwing his car on third down. Flushed out right. And he'll just get rid of it. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. Carr to throw for it on fourth down. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Raiders try it on fourth down, but to no avail. And the Lions will take over. On first down, it's gone. He's going to air one out. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far. But on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
He wants Reynolds way downfield. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call. But they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
Throwing on third, Goff. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Casey Hayward. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops.
You can easily see the logic. It's a tie game. They just wanted to press it a little bit right before the half, hoping to get one more score.
Yeah, easy to second-guess the result, but now you have to think after that interception, just a field goal, and they're behind at the break.
Yeah, I think at the half, the head coach just says, look, that's on me. I wanted to press it, but it's because I believe in you guys. That was nice work there defensively to force the incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
He gets it complete to Jackson. Now a timeout signal for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. On the handoff, this is Jacobs. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. The final shot here before half for Carr. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Raiders with the lead already, and they will get the football here as the second half is now underway. Out of the end zone comes Johnson, and ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, it didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Now a play fake. Carr rolling to his right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. Right now, the story of this game continuing to be the defenses, because the offenses, they're finding it difficult to establish any rhythm whatsoever.
I like how you come to us in praise of defense, Brandon, because that's exactly right. That was an incompletion force there, but we've seen it throughout this game. Both of these defense coordinators, they're a step ahead of their offensive counterparts.
Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. Carr. Waller taking it in over the middle. He's got this to the 30 before being taken down. Now Carr again. Forced out to his left. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. Jacobs, and he's over the line and in for a Raider touchdown. Josh Jacobs taking it in from 4 yards out, and the Raiders take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Extra point by Carlson, up and good, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
Right back to Swift again on second down. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Well, CD, a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast and in the open field, but, man, his first step is so quick, too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 39-yard line. Go off a handoff here to Swift. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6. Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Now a play fake, and it's gone. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Trayvon Merrig. And the Raiders are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. On play action, now Carr sliding out of the pocket. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And this one is incomplete.
They've been trying and trying, but they haven't sacked him yet. He's been able to get away and make plays. Tried to make another one downfield right there, but to no avail. They'll have to keep up the pursuit, though, and not let him get hot.
Carr's throw complete here to Waller. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. Here's a handoff to Jacobs. And this is going to be a Raiders first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line. 3 quarters in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So after 2 first downs, they get another here. 1st and 10 at the 45. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. They fake the handoff. Now Carr. They'll roll him out right. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. Oh, what a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch.
An important score there, CD, and now an important extra point because it would make it a three-score game.
Love the math there, and at this point in the fourth quarter, look, we all need next-gen stats, right? We all use them, but we don't need them here, do we? Because that means it's almost a certain victory.
And this one travels out of bounds, so unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. Play action. It's Goff. Throw left side complete. That's Kennedy. Not much there, only a yard. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. Now gone. And this will be incomplete. Boy, can you believe this? That one probably should have been picked too. Instead, it's fourth down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Casey Hayward. And the Raiders will have solid field position here as they take over at their 45-yard line. That is now five interceptions that he has thrown in this ball game. If I asked you to speculate what's possibly going on in his head, what would you say?
Well, if he's as mentally strong as I believe he is, he understands that not all of these picks have been his fault. You know, some of the throws, yes, but there have been a good number of them where he hasn't been helped by his own receivers, and they've turned into interceptions. So he knows if he keeps firing, perhaps good things can happen, not just in this game, but especially in later ones.
He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
Well, they did throw interceptions on their last two drives, so no surprise at all they decided to start it with a running play. I'm actually a little bit surprised, though, that they got as much out of it as they did.
Yeah, decent little gain. Puts them in a pretty good spot for second down. Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man, and you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
And he is going to have a Lions first down. They needed five there on third down. He winds up getting seven.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game, that's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Nate Hobbs. And the Raiders are going to take possession here at their own 3-yard line. Now after the INT, it's Carr. Throw right side, going to be caught by Waller. And he takes it all the way up to the 45-yard line. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. And that is incomplete.
After what they faced during this game where they've given up a ton of yards downfield, there has to be a measure of revenge right there for the secondary. They've been shredded throughout the game and finally forced an incompletion.
And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. It's a big play there for Vegas.
Even with the big lead here in the fourth, it still bombs away. And frankly, it's working. Why should they stop? Go ahead and keep firing away and gaining those yards.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Here's second and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a 4th down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
They'll go for it. It's Carr. And he finds Waller in the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Darren Waller, a beast in the red zone with his 2nd touchdown of the game. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And the lead is now 24. Stay disciplined.
It is difficult because you're so eager to go get the football. It's that type of a play, but you're exactly right. You have to have the discipline to let it go 10 first.
And they'll indeed take a knee. So this one, a victory for the Las Vegas Raiders. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one were thinking to themselves, I bet halftime was really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense it was much more of the adjustments they made. They came in with a game plan that we saw that didn't work in the first half. They made the adjustments necessary, went away from that, and then they got it together, got a spark, and then took off. It's really nice to watch in the second half.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on ESPN.